So I'm here with Colton Titus. He's a member of the Centralia College baseball team. And so, Colton, first question I have for you, it's the alumni game. You know, it's fun, it's goofing off, but what's it mean to you to see these guys who are, you know, coming back and representing the college?
It's actually pretty sweet. I mean, honestly, last year we got rained out, so we didn't get to experience the alumni game, and it really kind of sucked because we, you know, these guys are our present and we're their future, and so they started the program and now we're building, you know, and we're going forward with it. But it's awesome to have them come back and, you know, see how much we've grown since they've been here. And it's just it's a lot of fun to play against the guys too, because a lot of the guys I've played with or have as had as coaches as well. So it's kind of a, you know, good kickoff to the season.
Yeah, you know, and it is a kickoff. It's fall ball, so the record doesn't count. But at the same time, you know, there's still a chance to improve, a chance to work on things. What are things you're focusing on and hoping to improve getting ready for spring?
First of all, we got to figure out who we are as a team, you know. I'm a team guy. I know, individually, I'll go do my own things. But as a team, we got to figure out who we are, you know, how we play together. And we're doing that Build the Base program. I'm sure you know about that. And so, you know, we're just working to get better. You know, we want to shock the nation. We want to be that surprise. So we're working towards that, and we're just trying to figure out who we are and how we're going to do it.
And it really is a different mindset for Centralia than what it has been in the past. I know I remember seeing the team a few years ago, and it was just guys who made the team were just there to have fun and goof off. But this year, it's about business, about getting the job done. So what's it been like for you as a player, having a new coaching staff, new head coach, and really being a part of that change?
It's actually awesome because we're the start of something new. So, you know, like you said, last year we were competitive. I think we could have been better, you know, but we were competitive. And then this year we're going to show how much better we could have been or how much better we're going to be. And, you know, it's honestly awesome to be a part of the start of something that's going to be great in the future. And I'm proud to be a part of that.
And then, you know, to get better, you know, as a team, you have to work together. But as an individual, you have to be motivated, you have to push yourself. But you also need people behind you doing that as well. Who in your life has been that inspiration, that really motivator for you?
My dad. You know, growing up, he was my coach, you know. And, you know, it sounds bad, but you go 3-for-4, and instead of saying, you know, hey, you know, nice job, I mean, he does, he, you know, he's there, but he's like, hey, next time on that, you know, that one swing, here's what you need to do different, you know. And, you know, as a child, you don't realize how much it impacts you as you get older, but now I realize exactly what it's been like, you know. And my dad, he always told me when growing up, he goes, play it as long as you can, because I feel like he missed the opportunity that he wanted to have, and he didn't take advantage of it. And so I'm doing what he's telling me to do. I'm taking his advice, and I'm playing the game I love so much as long as I possibly can.
Yeah, definitely play the game you love as long as you can until you take the bat out of your hand and you can't do it anymore. And then, you know, for a lot of players, as they make it to this level, you know, they kind of mimic players, you know, they've seen on TV, Major League Baseball. Is there a player you've looked at and say, no, I love the way they approach the game, I love the way they just attack the ball? Is a Major League player you just kind of said, you know what, I like that style?
Mitch Haniger. Mitch Haniger, you know, he's got the swagger, but he's humble. You know, he's not Mr. Flashy, you know, and I want to represent that, because I don't want to be that guy who everyone looks up to, but also tries to act like, because of the way he plays flashiness, you know, if you know what I mean. But Mitch Haniger, he's a gamer, he's a stud, and he's there 100% of the time, and, you know, I think he represents a true player of the game, and that's what I really like about him.
You know, and definitely he's one of those guys that Mariners got in that trade that everybody kind of overlooked, but definitely a great young player. And then, you know, also for you, you're from Castle Rock, so not far from Centralia. So it's not a hometown team for you, but at the same time, it's still pretty close where you know, kind of know the area, your family can be up here. What's it like to play, you know, this close to home?
It's actually really nice, you know. I mean, we're grinding 24/7, but when we're not grinding, I'm not too far away from home, so I can go see family. Or, like you said, they can come up and watch games. And, you know, like LC, growing up, I watched them for years, you know, and everyone wants to play there, but they're a good program and they're tough to get into. But, you know, now it's just awesome. You know, I live up here, so it's not too far to commute back and forth to home. But, you know, you get the living on your own experience, and you get the freedom and the responsibility as a young adult. But you also have your home not too far away, which is really, I'm really fortunate to have, because I got basically the best of both worlds there.
Absolutely. And last question I have for you, obviously you see a lot of kids at games, that type of stuff. What's it like for you to see that? And what advice do you have for those young players who want to make it to the next level? You know, what would you just encourage them to do?
Don't let anybody tell you you can't do it. A lot of people, you know, they say you're too small or you're not athletic enough. No, keep grinding. You're your own person. Do it yourself. If you believe in yourself, you can do whatever you want. And basically, don't stop until you know it's your time. Just because someone tells you you can't do it doesn't mean you can't.
Awesome. Well, thank you very much.
Thank you.